The top of 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 Tonight to the 2024 Monavay Presentation Ball. My name's Dale Minney and I'll be your MC for this evening. A little bit of housekeeping before we start. The toilets to my left here, up the side here. This is a no smoking venue, inside and outside, and also no alcohol inside and outside. I'd ask you to make sure that your phones are turned onto silent or aeroplane mode. To the people upstairs there, the lights up there get very hot. So if you're moving around, please don't touch any of the lights or you'll burn your hands. I think that's all the housekeeping. So now we're ready to welcome our official party. We've got our Monavay Principal, Mr. Jonathan Rowe and Mrs. Rachel Rowe. Special guest for this evening, Mr. James McKenzie AO and Ms. Flavia Gobbo. Monavay Deputy Principal Fiona Mulhall and Mr. Shannon Mulhall. Senior Level Coordinator Mr. Sophia Veering. St. Mary's Parish Priest Father Paddy McGovern. And our dance instructors, Trevor and Sarah Ellington. Without further ado, we now present to you our 83 presentees for 2024. The first group consists of Madison Baker, Lachlan Burke, and Joshua Atkinson. Madison comes from MacArthur, and when she leaves school, hopes to pursue a career in the agriculture industry. Maddie would like to thank her mother and brothers for always supporting and encouraging her. Lachlan lives at Breakaway Creek, and when he finishes school, his ambition is to go to study agriculture and become a stock agent. Lachlan would like to thank his family for always showing him love and compassion and for coming to tonight's presentation ball. He values his friends and is grateful for the good times they have together. Joshua is from Taranlea, and after a successful year 12, his dream is to be a pilot. Josh is very grateful to his family for all the driving to and from Presentation Bull training and for coming to watch tonight. In group number two, we have Madison Atchison, Madeline Barr, and Thomas Brown. Madison lives at Tarrinlea. And after a gap year, Madison would like to study a career in speech therapy at university. Maddie would like to thank her parents and grandparents for their ongoing love and support, and her special guests for all that they do for her. Madeline comes from Alice Street. While Maddie is unsure what the future holds for her, she knows it will involve some travel in Australia and overseas. Maddie would like to thank her family for loving her, making her laugh, and giving her so many wonderful opportunities. Thomas is from Hamilton, and his ambition is to explore the world by taking a gap year before deciding on his future. He would like to express gratitude to his family for being here tonight and for supporting him. The next group of presentees are Ebony Atkinson, Esther Biggin, and Bodie Cameron. Ebony is from Lake Bolac and intends to take a gap year before studying nursing and paramedicine at university. She hopes to end up working somewhere near her siblings. Ebony wants to thank her mother for being a role model of resilience through tough times. She's also grateful to her siblings who stick by her and are her best friends. Ebony wants to acknowledge her other close friends who have always been there for her. Esther resides in Hamilton, and her post-school goal is to travel and volunteer amongst needy communities in countries overseas. She would like to express her gratitude to her mum and dad for all they do for her. She wants to thank her sister for always pushing her and getting her to school when this was hard. Bodie lives in Penshurst. When he completes school, Bodie will be looking for an interesting and productive job that allows him to travel and experience life. He would like to extend his thanks to mum, dad, and the rest of his family for attending tonight's presentation hall. In the next group are Noni Blanchett, Zach Elliott, and Campbell Glazebrook. Noni comes from Hamilton and is dreaming of her post-school life, where she hopes to travel to Italy and Iceland, experiencing their different cultures. Noni would like to thank her mum, dad, and sister for all that they have done for her, and most importantly, everyone who has helped make this presentation ball possible tonight. Zach lives in Hamilton, and when he completes his education, he hopes that it leads to a career somewhere in the sports industry. Zach wishes to express his thanks to his mum, dad, and two brothers for their love and support. He is grateful to his friends for the good times they have shared over the years. Campbell lives in Dunkeld, and after a successful year 12, he would like to study physiotherapy. He would like to thank mum Fiona, dad Rob, and sister Lillian for supporting him, encouraging him, and taking him everywhere for all his commitments. He is grateful to the teachers at Monavay College for helping him to work towards his future. Group 5 consists of Tara Bond, Michaela Bygate, and Charlie Fitzpatrick. Tara lives in Antwerp and after graduating plans to study to become a vet. Tara would like to thank the team who made it down here to watch her tonight and to her new friends who have made this such an enjoyable experience. She would also like to thank her dad for taking the time out of his days to drive her around for hours on end. Michaela lives in Hamilton. When school is completed, Michaela wants to head up north and work on a station for 12 months before going to university to become a vet. Michaela would like to thank her family for always being there to support her when she needs it. The appreciation she has for them is unreal. Charlie is from Tarrington, and after finishing year 12, he would like to study architecture. He would like to thank his family for coming to watch him tonight and is grateful to his parents for paying all the expenses that this night entails. In the next group are Grace Cleaver, Oliver Foster, and Joshua Gardner. Grace is from Hamilton, and once she graduates, she wants to find a low-stress career that allows her to travel, have fun, and enjoy life. Grace would like to thank her family for everything they've done for her, especially her sisters who have helped her become the person she is today. Oliver lives in Casterton, and when he graduates, he would like to be an aeronautical engineer or a fast jet pilot in the Australian Defence Force. Oliver would like to thank his mother, father, and sister for everything they do. Oliver is grateful to his grandparents who watch his sport every week and give him opportunities to work in different environments. Joshua lives in Hamilton, and his dream is to be an offshore oil rig engineer. Joshua would like to thank his parents for loving him, and he wants his friends to know how much they mean to him. The next group to be presented are Tabitha Detling, Mia Doyle, and Harley Manson. Tabitha lives at Nebsworth, and her plans for after school include spending time in the army before eventually joining the police force. Tabitha is grateful to her parents, Rachel and Craig, for showing her unconditional love and support. She also thanks her sister Clara for helping prepare her for tonight. Mia comes from Casterton, and whilst she's still unsure about her career in the future, she hopes to study at a university either in Melbourne or Geelong. Mia would like to thank her parents for always helping and supporting her, for taking her places and giving her some great opportunities. Harley is from Hamilton and is looking forward to travelling and working in Queensland after year 12. Harley would like to thank his mum and dad, his sister Bella, who always encourage him to succeed, and his sister Willow, who showed him that you can survive through anything. He's grateful to his mum for always listening and to his dad for showing him how to be a good person. The next group consists of Phoebe Dunn, Taya Evans, and Thomas Gordon. Phoebe resides in Hamilton. After Phoebe graduates, she would like to take a gap year and gain some experience before going to university where she might study psychology. Phoebe would like to thank her family, particularly her mum and dad, for loving and supporting her. Taya lives at Ridbrit, and once school is complete, she will take a gap year before working hard to further expand her business. Taya would like to thank her parents for all the love and laughter, along with her Ema, Wumpa, Nana, Auntie Rita and Cole for travelling up from Melbourne. She would also like to thank Kyle and Sian for always being there for support. Thomas is from Dunkeld, and following year 12 and further study, he would like to become a successful businessman. Tom would like to thank his mum and dad for their love and support, and is grateful to his friends for the fun they bring to his life. In the following group, we have Charlize Fairbairn, Olivia Houlihan, Hugh Fitzgerald, and Alexander Gunning. Charlize resides at Hillgay, and her post-school ambition is to obtain an accounting degree at Swinburne University before becoming a partner in her family farm. She would like to thank Nan and Pop, Dad, Joe, Grandma, Grandpa, and her brother, Baden, for showing her unconditional love always. Olivia lives in Hamilton, and when she graduates from school, she would like to spend a year travelling and working around the country before beginning a career in the agriculture industry. Olivia would like to thank her family for making her participation tonight possible, and also thanks her friends for making it such an enjoyable experience. Hugh lives in Hamilton, and when he graduates, he'll be looking for a job in the field of plumbing. Hugh is grateful to his mum and pa for their love and support and for helping him with everything he does. He also wants to thank his friends for the way they make life fun. Alexander is from Hamilton and has ambitions to be a builder once he finishes school. He's grateful to his family, friends, and everyone who helped make tonight possible. The next group to be presented is Scarlett Hinton, Isabella Holmes, Angus Impey, and Luke Hannick. Scarlett resides in Hamilton, and once she has finished school and completed a gap year, is looking to study teaching. Scarlett is very grateful to her family for all their support, and would like to thank her friends for being there when she needs them. Isabella lives in Hamilton, and when she finishes school, Bella would like to take a gap year to travel before beginning a Bachelor of Science. Bella would like to acknowledge her mother as her best friend and main supporter. She thanks her dad for being comic relief, and her brother and sister for being amazing siblings. She is grateful to all her other family and special people for being here tonight. Angus comes from Portland and plans to one day go to university to study sports journalism. Angus would like to thank his parents for supporting him and travelling to watch his presentation ball, and he is also grateful to his friends for the good times. Luke comes from Portland. When Luke finishes school, he would like to travel around Australia and then go on to tertiary study at university. He would like to thank his mum and dad and his grateful to dance instructors Trevor and Sarah for all their hard work and dedication. In this group, we have Rory Mason, Hayley Jelly, and Mitchell Lewis. Rory resides in Balmoral and intends to become a forensic pathologist after spending time travelling around the world. Rory says that if she had to thank the person that has consistently helped her throughout life, that person would be her mother. Rory thanks her for always pushing her with her experiences and honesty throughout her life. Rory also wants to show her appreciation for her loving family. Hayley is from Hamilton, and her dream is to use the gap year to explore the world, painting along the way. Ultimately, Hayley hopes to pursue an education in engineering or graphic design. She would like to thank her mum and dad for supporting and encouraging her throughout her life, along with the family who have travelled to be with her tonight, specifically her fairy godmother and her brother. Mitchell is from Drumborg, and once he has finished school, he is looking forward to extensively travelling the world. He would like to thank his parents, friends and teachers for everything they have done to help him get this far. Presenting next, we have Emily Jelly, Maria Martin, and Fergus MacDonald. Emily lives in Hamilton and looks forward to graduating from school so that she can take a gap year and use it to figure out what she wants to do with her life. She would like to thank her parents for putting up with her and is grateful to her godmother and brother for making the journey to be with her tonight. Maria resides in Hamilton and after completing Year 12 is very keen to pursue a career in medicine. Maria is very grateful to her family, especially her parents, for always supporting and encouraging her when she needs it. Fergus is from Hamilton, and when he finishes school, he is hoping to be a farm manager. He would like to thank his family for being here tonight, as well as thanking the Presentation Bull team for their hard work. Our next group consists of Tiana Keegan, Will MacDonald, and Katatu Keighley. Tiana lives in Bulwarra. Tiana's plans after graduation involve earning some money through having a good job, travelling around Australia while she decides where life will lead her. She's grateful to her parents for always being there for her and for helping her pursue her sporting commitments. Tiana would like to thank Tigra for being the best friend in the whole world. Will resides in Warrnambool and after he finishes his education, is looking forward to training as a diesel mechanic. Will is thankful for his family, especially his parents, and would also like to thank his teachers for giving him a great opportunity to fulfil his dream occupation. Katato comes from Branksome Wallisdale. Once finishing school, Katato thinks he will spend time travelling the world, enjoying life and playing lots of sports. He's very thankful that his mum and dad have always been there for him, and he's really grateful that his sister and grandmother have travelled all the way from New Zealand to be here tonight. Next we have Stella Kent, Harriet Kent, and Edward McShane. Stella resides in Casterton and has ambitions for the future that include travel and a career in the health industry. Stella would like to thank her parents and siblings, especially Violet, for travelling such a long way to be here tonight. Harriet comes from Casterton and in the future has an interest in travelling and a long-term goal to become a beautician. She would like to thank her family and friends for supporting her. A special expression of thanks goes to her mother and father's bank account for paying for this special event. Edward is from Glen Thompson, and although he's unsure of his future career, he does want to go to university in Melbourne and continue playing football, cricket and golf down there. Eddie would like to thank his parents for always supporting him and putting food on the table, and he's very thankful to his brother Harry, who always kicks the footy with him. Our next group of presentees consists of Bridget Males, Riley Munro, and Hamish Myers. Bridget lives in Hamilton, and when school is finished, she wants to travel during a gap year before going on to study something that she loves at university. Bridget would like to thank her parents and siblings for supporting her and helping her to grow as a person. She would also like to express gratitude to the Presentation Ball Committee for putting this wonderful evening together. Riley is from Hamilton, and one day he will be a plumber after finishing school and undertaking the necessary education. Riley would like to thank his parents for being great, his friends for making life fun, and the team behind tonight's presentation ball. Hamish comes from Tahara, and when he finishes school, he would like to go shearing and then work on the farm. Hamish would like to thank his mum, dad, and sisters for everything they have done. He wants to especially thank his grandfather for taking him to town after work for cricket and for presentation ball practices. In our next group, we have Addison Linskins, Felicity McClure, and Flynn Northcote. Addison is from Dunkeld, and her ambition is to graduate school, study, and become a teacher. Addison is thankful that her grandparents could attend tonight's ball, and is grateful to her parents for all that they have done for her. Felicity lives in Culla, and her ambition is to become a nurse after travelling for some time after Year 12. Felicity would like to thank her parents for everything they have done for her and for supporting her through everything. Flynn from Hamilton hopes one day to become an apprentice bricklayer, ultimately running his own business. He would like to thank his family for being here tonight, supporting him and financing his involvement tonight. The next group to be presented is Tara McIntyre, Jessica Mead, and Archie Page. Tara lives at Douglas. When Year 12 is complete, Tara would like to travel with her friends for a while before going to university to pursue a career. Tara is thankful to her parents and friends for their support each day. She is grateful to her friends for being her strong supporters and to the organisers of tonight's event. Jessica is from Drumborg, and her future dreams include completing a hairdressing apprenticeship and working up north on a cattle station for a year. Jess would like to thank her parents for everything they have done to prepare her for this night, and she would also like to thank Michaela for her hospitality on practice nights. Jess is really grateful for all the things that her friends and family do for her. Archer resides in Penshurst, and when he graduates, he is very hopeful that he can take over his grandmother's chook business. He would like to say thank you to his friends and family for their ongoing support of his interests. This group consists of Mia Milano, Benjamin Peace, and Brody Phillips. Mia comes from Haywood, and once finishing her hairdressing apprenticeship, wants to travel and work overseas in this field. After returning to Australia, she hopes to complete an interior design and fashion design course and run her own business. Mia would like to thank her closest family members for helping her become the person she is today. She wants to thank her friends for making every day something to look forward to. Ben lives in Dunkeld, and in the future wants to become an electrician. He would like to thank his mother, father and grandparents for all the support they have given him. Ben is grateful for the opportunities that they have given him and thanks them for letting him be the best person he can be. Brodie lives at Narrapamulik South. Brodie's not sure what the future will bring, but he's keeping his options open. He would like to thank his parents for helping pursue all of his sporting opportunities and all the travel that comes with this. The next group of presentees are Emma Parker, Claire Peace, and Emma Parker. Alexander Prentice. Emma resides in Hamilton. At the moment, Emma is really unsure of what her career will be, but knows that it will involve helping people in some way. Emma would like to help thank her parents for always supporting her and looking out for her. She would also like to thank Caitlin for being a constant support. Emma is very grateful that you came into her life. Emma is also very grateful to her friends for always making her smile. Claire Pearce lives in Hamilton and eventually dreams of going to university to become a paramedic. Claire would like to thank her parents and grandparents for all the time they spend helping transport her around to all the activities that she enjoys. Alexander is from Dunkeld and at present he's still exploring his options for life after school. He would like to thank his family and friends for making each day a great one. Next we have Isabel Perkins, Tiffany Powell, and Jack Rook. Isabel lives in Hamilton, but when she graduates from school, would like to have a gap year, move to Melbourne, and study psychology at university. Izzy is grateful to her parents for supporting her with everything she wants to do. Tiffany resides in Hamilton, and when she finishes school, she intends to study nursing. Tiffany would like to thank her nan and pa for their endless support and for giving her all they have to make sure she gets a good education in the future. Tiffany wants to say that she loves them and appreciates them very much. Jack comes from Marino, and once he has graduated from school, he's hoping to go into a trade-related area such as carpentry or joinery. Jack would like to thank his mother and father and grandparents for everything they do for him and for taking him to all his sporting commitments. Presenting next is Anna Wrench, Isabel Pye, and Daniel Spillman. Anna resides in Penshurst. When Anna graduates, she would like to travel with her friends to various interesting parts of the world where she can pursue her interests. Anna would like to thank her mum and dad for coming tonight and her friends and family for making this night such a special one. Isabel comes from Penshurst and is very interested in becoming a teacher after her graduation from school. Isabel would like to thank her mother and father for supporting her decision to be involved in the presentation ball tonight. She's grateful to her mother's friend for the lend of a hairpiece she's wearing tonight. Daniel lives in Hamilton, and when he graduates year 12, he would like to study engineering at Melbourne University. Daniel would like to thank his parents, grandma, his friends and family, along with the presentation ball committee and teachers who helped to supervise all aspects of tonight's event. Thank you. An extra to be presented tonight are Stella Rogers, Jack Roberts and Archie Sheldon. Stella resides in Portland and has big plans for her future, including a gap year with family, travel in Europe and attending university at the end of that. Stella would like to thank her parents and everyone who has had a part in raising her and making her the person she is. She's very grateful to her close friends and family, especially her big brother Aidan, for getting her through the last 12 months. Jack is from Hamilton and is looking forward to going to university in the future. He is grateful to his family for attending tonight, as well as his friends for making things better each day. Archie is from Hamilton and is looking forward to studying environmental science at Monash University after a successful VCE. He's grateful to his mum and dad who have supported and encouraged him to do his best his whole life. The next group consists of Lexi Smith, Ruby Whitehead and Joshua Robinson. Lexi is from Vasey and is looking forward to travelling around the world with her three best friends after graduating. She would like to thank her parents for supporting her dreams and is thankful to her two sisters who are her biggest role models. Ruby is from Mount Gambier and also has ambitions to travel with her friends when school is complete. She wishes to thank her supportive parents and her sisters for being the best role models for her. Joshua is from Eden Hope and is looking forward to being a farmer in the future. He is grateful to his parents and family and would like to thank the Presentation Ball Committee and helpers for making tonight possible. Next to be presented are Imogen Thomas, Edward Whitehead, and Jacob Shrive. Imogen lives at Beulart, and her dream for after school includes continuing her netball career and travelling the world to see new places. Imogen would like to thank her parents for everything they have done for getting her ready and supporting her through her sport. She thanks them for always being there for her. Edward is from Eden Hope, and at the moment he is unsure what his pathway will be after school. He would like to thank his parents and siblings for their support, all his teachers throughout the years, his mates for their friendship, and the team who put this evening together. Jacob is from Douglas, and after he graduates from school, hopes to train as a diesel mechanic and then go on to work on his family farm. Jacob would like to thank his mum, dad, sister and other family members for all their support over the years. He would also like to thank his mates for their friendship, being by his side over the journey. Our next group tonight consists Isabel Scarp, Madison Tonneson, and Mason Shieldrake. Isabel lives in Hamilton. Before going to university to study primary school teaching, Isabel hopes to travel and explore the world. Isabel would like to thank her nan and her mum for being her role models and for helping her with her dress. She would also like to thank her sister Saskia for her constant encouragement and support. Madison is from Hamilton. When she graduates after year 12, Maddie would like to travel and figure out the rest of her life whilst on the journey. Maddie would like to thank her parents and and sister for always being there to guide her and for everything they have done for her. Mandy would also like to thank her Nana Degia for taking on the role of altering her dress tonight. Mason resides in Hamilton. Mason's ambition after finishing school is to be a shearer and travel extensively doing this work. Mason would like to thank his family for being here tonight, as well as his cousins. The next group to be presented are Georgia Dewinson, Ella Wilmot, and Jordan Tregeagle. Georgia lives in Melbourne, and after year 12, she hopes to attend Monash University, complete a medical degree, and become a paediatric surgeon. She hopes to take her knowledge and expertise around the world whilst experiencing different cultures at the same time. Georgia would like to thank her mother for always believing in her and for being her number one supporter and best friend. Georgia would also like to thank her sister for inspiring her and always being by her side. Ella is from Horsham, and her ambitions for the future include completing her hairdressing apprenticeship, travelling during a gap year before living near the beach and opening her own salon. Ella would like to thank her family for supporting her and driving all this way to participate in the evening with her. Ella is grateful to her friends for their constant support. Jordan resides in Hamilton, and in the future he aims to study to become a heavy diesel mechanic. He would like to thank his parents for always helping him with his homework and for supporting him no matter what. Final group of presentees for the evening are Ava Sobey, Zach Wanalock, and Kobe Slattery Fisher. Ava resides in Hamilton, and after leaving school, she wants to travel for a while with her friends before going to university. Ava would like to thank her mother and father for being the best friends, and her friends have always been there. Zach is from Melbourne, and after school will pursue a university education in Melbourne or overseas to become an aerospace engineer. He is grateful to his parents for their endless love and support. He would like to thank all the teachers he has had who have encouraged him to excel, and all the people who have worked to make tonight possible. Kobe is from Hamilton and is currently completing a school apprenticeship, which will lead to a job as a builder in the future. He's grateful to his whole family, including Mum, Dad, Gran and Pop, and would like to thank his teachers and all the presentation ball committee for their hard work. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for our presentees. I now call on Father Paddy Mugovan to say a prayer for us.
God of infinite goodness, source of all life and love, we rejoice this night and give you thanks for all our young people, each of them so unique and so special and so gifted, and all those who have formed and shaped them through their lives, most of all their parents and family who have loved them to this night. We give you thanks too for other significant people in their lives, the school staff, And we pray that all their hopes and dreams that they've expressed will come to fruition. We give you thanks for this night, the love that's shared here. And we pray that we may all know that we can make a difference in our world. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
So we have four dances tonight. So our dances will be the tango to Lose Yourself by Eminem, the evening three-step to Dance the Night Away by Dua Lipa, the moringa to Geronimo by Shepherd, and a theatrical dance to Haya by Outcast. I'll now ask the students to take their positions for the first dance. She did.
Just come along for the ride. Oh, my outfit's all tight. You can see my heartbeat tonight. I can take the heat, baby. Best belief, that's the moment I shine. Cause every romance shakes and it bends. Don't give a damn. When the night's here, I don't do tears, baby, no chance. I could dance, I could dance, I could dance. Watch me dance, dance the night away. My heart could be burning, but you won't see it on my face. Watch me dance, dance the night away. I'll still keep the party burning, I wonder out of place. Lately, I've been moving close to the edge. I still be looking my best. I stay on the beat, you can count on me. I ain't missing no steps. Cause every romance shakes and it bends. Don't give a damn. When the night's here, I don't do tears, baby, no chance. I could dance, I could dance, I could dance. Watch me dance, dance the night away. My heart could be burning, but you won't see it on my face. Watch me dance, dance the night away. I'll still keep the party running, I wonder out of place. When my heart breaks, when my world changes, I don't play safe. Don't you know about me? I could dance, I could dance, I could dance. Even when the tears are flying, the diamonds on my face, I still keep the party going, not one hair out of place. Yes, I can. Even when the tears are flying, the diamonds on my face, yes, I can. I still keep the party going, not one hair out of place. Watch me dance, dance the night away. Burning, but you won't see it on my face. Watch me dance, dance the night away. I'll still keep the party burning, I wonder out of place. When my heart breaks, when my world
takes. I don't pay safe. Don't you know about me? I could dance, I could dance, I could dance. Dance tonight.
Of the waterfall. When I lost it, yeah, you held my hand, but I tossed it. Didn't understand you were waiting as I dove into the waterfall. So say that you're on the road. As a broken man, but I found my friend. Now I'm falling down through the crashing sound, and you come around. And you rush to me and it sets us free, so I fall to my knees. So say that you're on the road. Say that you're on the road. Say that you're on the road. Say,
I'm the roof is on, so get out of the bottom. The top is high, so love is on the bottom. Giving is good, as long as you're getting. What's happening, it's a vision I'm betting. I said I fall. Do you think you are? Do you think you are?
It's now my privilege to introduce you to tonight's guests of honour, James McKenzie and his wife, Flavia Gobbo. James is an alumni of Monavay College, has a long and distinguished career in business and public administration, was a founding director of the Monavay College Foundation, and is currently chair of the Monavay College Board. He has recently been recognised as an officer of the Order of Australia. Flavia is also a recent recipient of the Medal of the Order of Australia, has made a significant contribution to Rowing Australia, and is widely recognised for her services to business and to public administration. We warmly welcome them both and are grateful that they have accepted this invitation. I would like to invite James to say a few words.
Thanks very much. I just reflected as I was sitting in this room that there was never anything as grand as this at Monavay when I was at school here. Of course, I'd like to take the opportunity to thank all of you for the tremendous effort that you've gone to prepare for this evening. The guys looked a little bit nervous, but the girls looked very confident, and that was good to see. I did actually go to a get-together of old collegians, roughly my age, a couple of weeks ago. We get together every St. Pat's Day. And one of them, who was not at all respectful in the way in which he did anything at school, and things haven't changed over the years, asked me what the chairman of the board does. And I said, well, I've been invited tonight, along with Flavia, to come along for the presentation ball. And he said, well, remember back in 1971, you were the MC at the cadet dance. And all you did is talk too long and prattled on about Hawthorne, who just happened to be in the grand final this week. So I'm not going to prattle on tonight. That was the advice I got, other than just to say what a privilege it is to be here. Congratulations on all of you. And if you could have seen the faces on your parents and your special guests as this event unfolded this evening, you would have been very proud. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, Mr. McKenzie. I now call on Katate Keatley and Bella Holmes to come forward and to speak on behalf of the students being presented tonight.
I'd like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, the Gunditjmara people, both past, present and emerging. Good evening, Mr. and Mrs. Rowe, Mr. McKenzie and Ms. Gobbo, Father Paddy, friends and family of the participants in tonight's presentation ball. On behalf of all the students here tonight, I'd like to thank Monavay College and the Parents and Friends Association for for making this opportunity available to us. The presentation ball is an iconic part of Monavay College life, and although it has changed in format and style from past years, it remains as relevant to our students as ever. Our school theme this year is Be a Part of the MSC Heart, and our challenge is to express this theme in everything we do. The MSC Heart is deeply embedded in this event. The joyful fun it practices, small acts of kindness, generosity of spirit, patient listening, empathy, and respect for others reflect the MSC Heart. And as well as all these things, we learnt what we could do with hard work, commitment, and effort. Most importantly, we have been able to experience the fun and joy that comes from connecting with each other as a community. In contrast to all the factors which can separate us, this event has brought us closer together, renewing and building relationships. I'd like to thank Mr. McKenzie for his attendance tonight. It was inspiring to hear from an old collegian who is still connected to our school and its MSC values. Please accept this gift on behalf of our school. Thank you also to Mr. Minnie, our MC for tonight, whose impeccable performance has ensured that the evening has gone smoothly.
We would like to acknowledge the hard work of the 2024 Presentation Bowl Committee, who have managed to turn the traditional sports stadium into a place of elegance. We're aware of the hours of planning, decorating, and the care that has happened to lead up to this tonight's event, and we thank you all for giving your time to make this a memorable night. Presentation ball would be nothing without dancing. We're very thankful for your expertise and energy of the instructors, the Ellingtons, and their two children have attended all practices throughout the weeks. Trevor and Sarah have been very patient and kind, laughing with us when we missed our steps. Great sense of achievement we feel tonight is thanks to them. Hopefully we are able to give you a great night of dancing and fun. Please accept this gift from the thanks of the Year 11 students. Finally, thanks to the presentation ball coordinator, Mrs. Pauline Perkins. Pauline continues to amaze us with all of her generous donations over time and her absolute dedication to the Year 11 students at Monavay. We love the way you focus on this event, being inclusive and fun, and it is clear that you care very much for all of the students at Monavay College. On behalf of us, I would like you to come and accept this gift of appreciation. This year has been supported by a big team of parents taking on responsibilities within the presentation ball committees. We are so grateful to all of you and aware of how the stress and jobs may have caused you. We hope you can now enjoy and relax the night with us. On behalf of all the students, I'd like to thank everyone and the role they've played tonight's event. I hope you all had a fantastic evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Bella and Katato. I'd now like the students to take to the floor for an encore dance, the tango. Thank you.
Thank you. The roof is on, so get out of the bottom. The top is high, so you'll be some the bottom. Giving is good, as long as you're getting. That's not the news, I'm fishing, I'm betting. I said I'm
We're up to a special time in the evening where the students have the opportunity to dance with someone special to them. Tonight, the dance will be the evening three-step. Could the first group please take to the floor with their special person?
Get up now, 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 get
And with the second group now take to the floor with their special person.
Alive, alive, alive. Can you feel this vibe?
Now, for our final dance of the evening, I'd like all the students to select a special person and take the floor.
Love.
Ladies and gentlemen, official guests, friends and family of the presentees, this concludes the official part of the evening. Please join us for some supper in the East Stadium. There's also carbonated beverages, water and tea and coffee available. The music will continue throughout the evening. We wish to thank you all for coming and sharing this very special evening with us. We'll ask the presentees to perform a final dance at around 11 p.m. and we wish you a safe journey home at the end of this evening. I remind you once again, as you move down from upstairs, please make sure you're careful of those lights, and thank you very much.